Okay, hey guys, welcome back to my channel, Savvylicious Arrangements / Cooking with SJ. So today is going to be a haul video and it's late, so I am just going to get a move on it and I'm just going to go through this stuff pretty much as quickly as possible. I know it's a lot, but I wanted to get this video out here for you guys so that you can see all of the new things that I have picked up. Because business is starting to pick up. So I'm just going to start. I have multiple of some things, so I am just going to just skip through them. But these are the things that I wanted to show you. And if you would like to see a video on anything here that you see in this video, just leave it in the comments below. So I'm just going to start here with some little bling stickers, is what they call them. So I like to use these for like my candy apples and my strawberries. It has adhesive on the back of them. No, they're not edible, but you can just make sure candy apples and strawberries look a little more decent and more beautiful and colorful or whatever you want to call it. So, and these are the same things too. See if I can get the camera to focus on it. Okay, so these are the same thing. They're just different colors, and then they have the adhesive on the back, and so are these. And I got these from Michael's. Everything that I have in this video, I will leave it in the description box below. So make sure you go ahead and check that out. Okay, so moving right along, I am going to be starting with the silicones. So the silicone molds are like my new favorite thing. Like if you don't know how to do something, if you don't want to start from scratch by doing your own art, the silicone molds are the best thing for you. Now, I'm not really that good of an artist, but when you have silicone molds that does everything for you, then you should be fine. So these are the rolls. Molds. They're all the same roses, but they just have different sizes. You can use this in your oven. You can put hot candy mixture in this and let it form into the rolls, because I've done that before and it came out really pretty. You also can use this with fondant. Now, the best thing to do with this is the fondant is just to place the fondant on the inside of your mold and then let it sit for a little bit. Take the fondant out and let your fondant sit in a warm surface so that it can harden. If it continues to have moisture, like say for instance if you stick it in the freezer and then you take it out of the freezer, of course it's gonna thaw out. It would be hard while it's in the freezer, but once it thaws out, it'll be back to soft and gooey and sticky, and that's not what we want. So whenever you're working with fondant, just leave it out completely. Just sit it to the side somewhere and let it harden for itself. It's like Play-Doh. So when you leave Play-Doh out for a certain amount of time, it gets hard. And that's the same thing that you would do with your fondant. Most people don't eat the fondant unless it's like on a cake. But when you're doing decorations and roses and numbers and little different things, it's best to have the fondant sit out, and a lot of people don't eat them. So these are some heels that I have. This is a boot, this is a wedge, this is a stiletto, and I believe the next one is like a booty or something like that. I have a order coming up for a heel-a-thon. That's what they call it. They called it a heel-a-thon, which was cute. So I went and found me some heels, and I will be sticking those onto my candy apples. And these are basic numbers. 1, 2, 3, happy birthday, the pound sign, and the star sign. Something real simple. And this is, I can't remember what this flower is called, but I like the flower, so I just went ahead and got it. I didn't really care for the twig and the leaf. maybe I'll do a video showing you guys how it works. So I feel like my lighting is too bright. And I picked this up recently from a store called Surlatop in Virginia. I believe they have some stores in other locations, but even if they don't, I'm pretty sure you could find this at your local bakery store, your local cake supply store, wherever it is where they sell. Maybe Walmart even sells it. You can use it for strawberries to take out the stem, but I will be using it for either cupcakes to fill the center, or I'll be using it for apples, taking the core out of the apple and filling the apple with some type of filling, just to try something different. And this was $6.99. So I was just like, oh, okay, it was on clearance. And I believe it was an additional 50% off. So I think I paid about $3 for that. I got some roll gums. These are the pretty much luster dust. And the colors are really nice. They're really, really nice. Really pigmented and everything. They can be pricey, but these go a long way depending on how much you have. And I have some crystal. These are like edible glitters for decoration. And I have one for glow in the dark, where if you have a black light, it will glow. And the same with this one. It's called Alumo Gel. And this is a brand that comes from South Africa. This is the first thing that I got from them. But when I went to my local, it's not necessarily local, but when I went to my cake supply store, it's called Cake Craft Corner. And I will leave it in the description box with the address and phone number. If you are located in the DMV, DC, Maryland, Virginia, if you don't know what that means, I will leave it there. And if you are new to baking, making candy, making strawberries, or whatever it is that you call it, this is the best place to go. This is where I got majority of my, this is where I got all of my silicones. This is where I got my gold sheen, my Loran oils, my cookie cutters, my scalpel blades. You know, I got pretty much everything from there. This is a one-stop shop. You don't have to go anywhere. If you are a person that orders from Amazon or eBay and it takes a little long to get here, or if your stuff got lost in transit and they couldn't find it, they had to refund you your money, you had to do a discharge order, or dispute order, this is the best place to go. And I love it. This is where I always come to. So I have a Mickey Mouse or Minnie Mouse cookie cutter. I have some Loran oils. This is lemon oil. And this is strawberry kiwi. I have strawberry up in my cabinet already. I haven't used them yet. I would do a video on what the pigmentation is. This is my first one. This is pretty pricey. It was about $8 for just for this little tube. They have a full-size tube for $30. And I just didn't want to pay $30 for that right now. So moving right along, I have this Wilton Dab and Hold adhesive. I believe you use this for fondant and sticking fondant with fondant or fondant to the cake or whatever. I've used this before. It didn't really hold that well for me. So what I do is I just use this to add to my strawberries when I do my edible glitters. So I'll put a little bit in a bowl, take my brush, brush it onto my strawberry, take my edible glitter, sprinkle it on there, and we're done. And this is pretty much the same thing, but this is from Rokum's. And this works pretty good. I wouldn't say it's too bad. I've used it before. It works pretty good for me. These are my scalpel blades. I have to get the holder for the scalpel blades. So when I use my fondant or it's most likely for fondant. So that's what I'll be using it for. I haven't used them yet. Here's what everybody's been asking about, is this gold sheen food coloring from AmeriColor. Now these can be pricey. They run about $15, and if you order it from Amazon, it's the same exact price. Maybe if you order it from eBay, it can be a little cheaper, but once you pay for shipping, it'll probably take it right back to that same price. This is the Wilton's white coloring. I use this to make my candy mixture more pigmented. It gives it a base. So instead of me using a pink and it's transparent, I'll add the white to give it a base to make the color pop a little more. These are just little toothpicks that has 18 on it. I don't know why I got them. I was going to use them for my graduation candy apples, but since I was already putting a bunch of stuff on there, I didn't want to overwhelm them, so I never used them yet, but I'll figure out something. Someone will order something with 2018 on it, so I just got those. And this is a Charming Marvelous mold, and this is for decorating, and it's a silicone mold. And I thought this was really cute that I can put onto my candy apples. I thought the silicone mold was a little bigger than what it was because of the packaging and the advertisement on the packaging, but it's a very decent size. And I have some Bling Pop sticks for my candy apples or my Rice Krispie treats or even my cake pops. So, but most likely I'll be using these for my candy apples. I have a Chanel theme coming up for a lady who ordered candy apples for a Chanel theme birthday party. So I figured I'll probably use these for her order. And these were $5, and I got these from Hobby Lobby. And they only had 3 left, so I got all 3 of them. And these are pretty much the same things, but these are the sequence ones. And they only had 4 left of these, so I went ahead and got all 4 of them. And those run the same price as the Pearl Bling Pops. And I just got a cookie cutter that's a square, so I wanted to show you guys how to make the caps to the candy apples for the graduation one. So I'll do a video on that soon. And here are a bunch of luster dusts. This is from Rocom. This is super silver. It's really pretty. And this one is a soft gold. I have a lot of gold and a lot of silver. Those are the most two common ones, and it's like diapers, okay? You can never have too much of it. So this is a pretty purple luster dust. It's like a royal purple. They call it purple iris. That's the name of it. And this is more pinkish purple. And I believe this one is called Orchid. If I can get the price tag off of it. Yeah, it's called Orchid. And these run anywhere from $4.99 to $6.99, depending on the color. And this one right here is my favorite one. This one is called the Mayan Gold. I can't really explain it, but it's a really pretty gold. These are more of like a yellow gold, and that one is like a true gold. This one is more like a metallic gold. And I have some disco glitters. I have an order for strawberries, NFL glamberries. If you haven't seen my NFL glamberries, you can check it out on my Instagram page at Savvylicious Arrangements. I'll leave it in the link or description box below. That way you can just click on it. And this is called Imperial Silver. It's more like coin silver.